morning, dear students. In the previous class, we have learnt about some important formulas which are very much useful to do some numerical problems from unit 1. For example, what is the formula for numerical aperture? What is the formula for acceptance angle? And we have also derived the equation for acceptance angle also. What is the formula for the guided modes? How to calculate the guided modes? What is the formula for V number? What is the formula for cutoff wavelength, etc.? So many we have discussed in the previous class. Now today we'll discuss about we'll try to solve certain problems. Around one or two problems we'll do today. Very simple. The main prerequisite to do these problems are remembering the 5 to 6 formulas that were discussed in the previous class. Okay. See the first problem. See the question. A single mode step index fiber has a core diameter of 7 micrometer and core refractive index of 1.49. Estimate the shortest wavelength of light which allows single mode operation when the relative refractive index difference or refractive index difference for the fiber is 1%. Okay, so in the problem it is said that it is a single mode fiber. So what is single mode fiber? Any fiber, any optical fiber which can guide only one mode or one ray is called single mode fiber. Okay, so given that it is a single mode fiber, okay, so this single mode fiber has a core diameter of 7 micrometer. So let us write the given data, the solution for this. We will solve the solution. So first of all, we will write the given data for this. Okay, so what it is given? The core diameter of the single mode fiber. So core diameter is 7 micrometer. Next, core refractive index is 1.49. Core refractive index we represent using small n1 that we already discussed in the previous class, equal to 1.49. Okay, another thing, what is the given data? Relative refractive index or refractive index difference is 1%. Okay, so relative index difference, we call it as delta, equal to 1%, or you can call 0.01. Okay, so this is the given data. So this is the given data we have taken from the question. Okay, so what we have to calculate? So what it is asked? Estimate the shortest wavelength of the light which allows single mode of operation. We have to calculate the, or we have to estimate the wavelength of the light, okay, for which optical fiber can act as a single mode of optical fiber. Okay, so we have to find the wavelength lambda. This is the question. Okay. So let us see this. Okay. We already know formula, okay, V number. V number is also called as normalized frequency, is equal to pi into d by lambda into numerical aperture. Pi into d by lambda into numerical aperture. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to calculate the wavelength lambda. So bring this lambda this side to the left hand side, pi into d by v number into numerical aperture. Okay, here you see numerical aperture has a formula already we discussed in the previous class, root of n1 square minus n2 square, okay. So there is another relation between two refractive indices, that is relative refractive index, okay, that is n1 delta equal to n1 minus n2 by n1. Okay, we can rewrite using this relation, using this relative refractive index, that is delta, that relation, we can rewrite the numerical aperture as n1 into 2 delta whole power 1/2. Okay, you can rewrite the numerical aperture formula like this. Okay, so the same thing I am doing here. Pi into d by v n1 into 2 delta power 1/2. Okay, so remember here, in the question it is asked it is a single mode, what should be the wavelength, okay, calculate the wavelength such that the optical fiber acts as a single mode. Okay, so if you remember the previous formula, okay, so for cutoff wavelength, what is my cutoff wavelength? The wavelength above which the optical fiber acts as a single mode optical fiber. If you see that relation, the V number for that optical fiber will be equal to 2.4. For any single mode of fiber, the V number is 2.4. Okay, for any, you can write here. For optical fiber to operate in single mode, V number equal to 2.4. V number is equal to 2.4. Okay. So now you can calculate here pi into, what is d value? Remember, 7 into 10 power minus 6. That is given. 7 micrometer is the diameter. Next one is V number is 2.4. What is n1? 1.49 into 2 into, what is delta? It is given in the question itself, 0.01 power 1/2. Okay, so this is the wavelength. Now you take the calculator, you do this calculation. So whatever the value you are getting, it is equal to the shortest wavelength. Okay, for which the optical fiber can act as a single mode optical fiber. Okay, it is around 192 micrometer. Like this. Got it? So you can solve. So if you observe one point here, in order to calculate the wavelength, or in order to calculate the numerical aperture, or in order to calculate the acceptance angle, okay, so whatever you want to do, whatever the parameters you want to measure related to optical fiber, the important data you should know is the refractive indices of core and cladding. Okay, the refractive indices of core and cladding. These are the two parameters which are very much essential in order to calculate all other optical fiber parameters. Okay. Now we look into another problem. Okay, second problem. The given data is see the question. A multimode step index fiber with a core diameter of 80 micrometer. Okay, core diameter is 80 micrometer, and the relative index difference is around 1.5%, and is operating at a wavelength of 0.85 micrometer. Okay, so what it is, if the core refractive index is 1.48, core refractive index is also given. What you have to calculate? Estimate the normalized frequency, the number of guided modes. Estimate the normalized frequency and the number of guided modes. Okay, we need to find the solution for this problem. Very simple. First, write the given data, given information. What is that given data? You see here, it is a multimode step index fiber. Multimode step index fiber means that optical fiber can support more number of rays to propagate through it. It is called as multimode step index fiber. Okay. So whose core diameter is around 80 micrometer. So core diameter D equal to 80 micrometer. Okay. And next, its relative index difference is 1.5%. Okay, relative index difference means delta equal to 1.5% or 0.015. Okay, next is, it is operating at a wavelength of 0.85 micrometer. So wavelength is also given, 0.85 micrometer. Next, you see, if the core refractive index is 1.48, core refractive index is also given. You represent core refractive index with N1. It is 1.48. Okay. What you have to find? You have to find, the first one is normalized frequency. I already said in the previous class, V number is also called as normalized frequency. V number is also called as normalized frequency. Okay, so you need to calculate V number. Okay, so directly formula is there, yes or no? V number, V equal to, what is the formula? Pi into D, okay. What is that? Pi into D by lambda into numerical aperture, okay. But you can rewrite the same relation as pi into D by lambda numerical aperture. I am writing in another way, okay. Not like root of N1 square minus N2 square, as I said in the previous problem. Okay, you can rewrite as, how you can rewrite? N1 to delta whole power 1 by 2. N1 to delta whole power 1 by 2. Okay, so here the problem is, the important point is, you need to remember the formula for V number. Okay, you should be able to know the relation of numerical aperture with the relative refractive index. You need to able to write NA in terms of delta. What is the reason? If you observe, NA formula is root of N1 square minus N2 square. Here in the problem, only N1 is given. Core refractive index, N1 only given. N2, you need to find out actually. Okay, so from the given data, it is not possible. That is the reason. Okay, so we are utilizing the relative index difference, that is 1.5%, that is delta equal to 0.015 value, okay, in order to calculate. You are using relative refractive index delta, okay, so to calculate the NA, numerical aperture. That is the reason you are writing NA in terms of a relative refractive index, that is delta. So NA equal to N1 into 2 delta power 1 by 2. Okay, that is the reason you need to write the NA in terms of N1 into 2 delta power 1 by 2. Okay, so very simple, pi into D value already know, 80 micrometer. Okay, pi lambda you know, 0.85 micrometer into N1 you know, 1.48 into, okay, 2 into, what is delta? 0.015 power 1 by 2. You calculate this using the calculator, around, you will be getting around 76, V number around 76. Okay, you can take the calculator and do that simple calculation, you will be getting around 76 value. Okay, this is the one, okay, this is the first one, calculating the V number or normalized frequency. There is another question also, the number of guided modes. Why it is asked in the question? It is asked the number of, calculate the number of guided modes. How many modes or how many rays this optical fiber can guide? Okay, why it is asked? Because the optical fiber, given optical fiber is a multimode optical fiber. Multimode means many number of modes, many number of rays can be propagated through the optical fiber. Yes or no? That is the reason, many number means how many? Okay, that is the reason, how many number of modes can be traveled, how many number of light rays can be traveled in the optical fiber, or how many number of modes the optical fiber can support. Okay, that is the reason, since it is a multi-mode step index fiber, this question is asked. If it is single mode fiber, this type of question will not be asked. Okay, so second one is B. What is B? The number of guided modes. Number of guided modes. Very simple. This is, in the previous session we have discussed the formulas. Number of guided modes, MS equal to V square by 2. V square by 2. Okay. V means 76. 76 square by 2, around 2800 or around 3000, okay, around 3000 you will be getting the value, number of guided modes, MS equal to around 3000 modes, okay, 3000 rays the optical fiber can support, optical fiber can support. Okay, so this is how you need to estimate the normalized frequency as well as the number of guided modes. When you know the value of V, then you will be able to calculate the number of guided modes. Okay, the value of V or V number or normalized frequency, this value will be higher, okay, or will this value will vary or higher, more, that is more than 2.4, for multimode fibers only. See this, you compare the previous problem. Okay, what it is in the previous problem? The question is, it is a step index fiber. You need to calculate the wavelength such that it operates as a single mode fiber. Single mode fiber. So that is the reason what you have done, since it is a single mode fiber. Okay, so the V number will be 2.4 only. The V, because as per the definition, cutoff wavelength, the way, okay, what is the definition for cutoff wavelength? Wavelength above which this, the fiber acts as single mode, is called as cutoff wavelength. Okay, so for which V number is always 2.4, see the relation discussed in the previous class, it is 2.4. Okay, so that is the reason, in the previous problem, we have taken V number equal to 2.4, since it is single mode. Okay, but in case of multimode fiber, you can't do that. You need to calculate the V number. It will not be 2.4 because it is not a single mode. It is multimode fiber. Okay, So in order to understand the calculation of the problems between single mode and five multi mode, I have taken two examples here. Okay. See the third problem. See the third problem. This is the homework to you. Okay. But I will read out the question. Determine the cutoff wavelength for a step index fiber to exhibit single mode operation. To exhibit single mode operation, it is a step index fiber. Okay, it should be able to support only one mode or one ray. Okay, single mode operation when the core refractive index and radius are 1.46 and 4.5 micrometer respectively. Given data is core refractive index is 1.46, a n1 equal to 1.46, and radius is given, not the diameter. Okay, radius of the core is given, it is 4.5 micrometer. You need to convert into diameter while doing the problem. With the relative index difference is 0.25%, that is delta is given, delta equal to 0.25%. Okay, what you have to do, determine the cutoff wavelength, you have to calculate the lambda value. Okay, for which step index fiber acts as a single mode fiber, means you need to assume that V, that is V number or normalized frequency, okay, for a single mode as 2.4, like how we have done the first problem. In the similar fashion you have to do this problem. All of you do and tell the answer now itself, and we will move into the next topics in the coming classes. Okay, thank you very much.